As the president has, well, he appears to have been justifying the comments he made about founders. Let's listen to what he said.
I know that there are some who question this ceremony, that is 4th August as Founders Day, because they believe that we were all asleep in Ghana until the arrival of Kwame Nkrumah and the CPP. I have already stated my views on that several times, including in my speech last Saturday evening. I don't intend to go over that matter again. Suffice it to say that I believe that the consensus that Parliament arrived at in 2019, honoring Kwame Nkrumah with a Memorial Day and preserving the historical importance and significance of August 4th in our history, is a good consensus, and it deserves to last.
The debate continues.
Look, there are some debates that you know you won't win, and so you don't engage in. There are sometimes, for academic purposes, we write things, but on a political platform and in a political season, there are certain things you just don't say and do, because it would not only hurt you, President Akufo-Addo, but it also hurts your political party. So today, the antecedents of the NPP, the UP, and some of the things they said previously, pre-independence, is all over the country.
Yes, it's been shared. It's been shared. Because almost as if all that they did was to oppose independence.
Exactly. But this is it for me. Kwame Nkrumah, hate it or love it. Look, you may not be an Nkrumahist, but once you are a Ghanaian, you cannot deny the influence Kwame Nkrumah has on the African continent and the world at large. That today, when you meet other Africans and you say, I am from Ghana, the name they mention is Kwame Nkrumah. Yeah. History is on his side. President Akufo-Addo, stop this thing. You wanted to make it Founders Day. You have done that. People have forgotten about this and moved on. Then, in your last year as President of the Republic, you're still making these comments. Of course, nobody expects you to love Kwame Nkrumah since you are a diehard UPist. But you cannot take away his contribution. You cannot take away the fact that even the UGCC, bearing in mind the fact that they needed a good mobilizer, brought in Kwame Nkrumah. I'm not going to go back to the history days, but I'm just going to say that today, the African of the millennium, even Nelson Mandela, could not come close to Kwame Nkrumah. Why is it that those of us who are in Ghana who should be proud of the man that puts us on the world map are constantly trying to bring him down? I don't get it.
Can I say something? If there is something that makes the world proud of Ghana, it's Nkrumah. Anybody who demonstrates any desire to bring down one of our greatest contributions to the world is unpatriotic. It's as simple as that. You want to bring down one of the best things that has ever come out of our country. You want to bring it down so that your uncles can be elevated. That's unpatriotic. And you see, what is even painful is that now you've opened the doors for the truth of history to be shared, so that the shame that your uncles could have avoided because of the role they played, that sneaky snitching role that they played, when others were trying to ensure the speedy achievement of independence, and they were writing letters to white people, kissing backside, just so that they will think that as for them, they are their friends. Those things are now coming out. Why would you do this? I think President Akufo-Addo has a little bit too much time on his hands, because the whole country has shifted its focus to Bawumia. We are not holding his feet to the fire as our president. we are not holding him responsible for the things that are going wrong in our lives. So he's skating by, and he's got a bit of time on his hands, which is why the devil is making, you know, work for idle hands. Because if he was busy being president, this is not what his priority would have been. But because everybody is holding Baumia to account, because he wants to succeed him. So, and it's everyone, including the media. We are all focused on Baumia, what Baumia says, what Baumia does. But there is still a president that we elected, whose mandate still has time mileage on it. A good 4 months before he can say goodbye. Why are we not holding him to account for some of these? Why is he not sweating? Why does he have time to be making some of these ridiculous debates that are actually not even helping the fortunes of his party that wishes to break the eight? What is that? Anyway, that's my piece. Everybody is sharing their opinions. He shared his, I've shared mine. Let's move on. What's in the papers today?
Well, the biggest story on the front page of the Daily Graphic is Road to Election 2024, Experts Write Off Minority Parties. And that's on the front page with the other one, the president is here, and this is from Sunday. Nkrumah Not So Nation's founder. And we're just having that conversation, and sometimes it's difficult to continue on that path, but Akufo-Addo's debate is also what's being written there. Stakeholders call for more housing fairs. That's a graphic greater exhibition excites patrons. The other one is women heads of electoral bodies must consolidate democracy. This is the head of Ghana's election management body. That is Jemensa there on the front page with that story. The other stories that may be of interest to you, relay team carry Ghana's Olympic hopes. That's
I have seen the heat on Thursday. It's a very difficult one.
Oh, you said the hope is not hoping.
It's a cool job. This guy's there talking about cool chop.
Yeah, relay team will win. We'll win. I support and win it at every level. So I have hope that we will win something.
Oh, we have to win something.
Yeah, we have to win something.
We don't have to, you know. this year we don't have boxers in the Olympics, and so it's not looking good for us.
Okay.
But we need to win something.
Now, stop bastardizing state institutions. Presby Clerk is also on the front page. Reverend Dr. Godwin Ni Noi Odonko is also talking there. And peace in Boko is our priority. John Mahama is the one saying so. Those are the major stories on the front page of the Daily Graphic. Yeah.
Now, the Daily Guide this morning says NDP launches manifesto August 18. I have done my best. That's according to President Akufo-Addo. And there's also a story here. Let's stick to our founding fathers' ideals. Now that many of you like where the apostrophe is, let me just tell you that the apostrophe is after the S. So founding fathers' ideals. But gold exports to hit.
He said he's done his best.
Akufo-Addo, yes, he talks about the
fact. Has he finished?
No, he's not finished. But I think now.
You should say he's doing his best.
No, I think I mean, at this point in time, the man has told you that.
That mentality. No, he said
he's laid a strong foundation. Yeah. And the next NPP government.
Yes.
The next NPP government, in his words, will continue.
Yeah.
So he's done.
We'll fix the other problems.
Other problems, yes.
So he's done fixing problems.
Well, gold exports to hit $10 billion by the end of 2024. That's also a story here. We're told that we've exported some $5 billion worth of gold in the first half of the year. And we'll have constant electricity supply. That's Minister of State at the Ministry of Energy, Herbert Crapper, and Mike Okwe Jr. assist 570 WASI students also here. And back page says Jordan Schlupp shine in Palace Cup glory. Okay. That's Jordan Ayew. And that's it for the Daily Guide.
Now, the final is reporting this morning. Stay away from alcohol, drugs, pornography, and other vices. Pastor Dr. Otabel is the one advising. And this is good advice that young people in this country, including those who are advising them.
But why are you looking at Aaron while you're saying
because of
things.
The way he's moving his shoulders and doing all of those things. Yeah,
he's resisting the advice.
He's not listening to young people who are who do not want to take advice. This is prudent advice. Say, stay away from alcohol, drugs, pornography, and other vices. Other vices. This is sensible advice. That it is godly advice. That every young person, there's another one at the back too. Who is us in there? I've not seen. People are closing their ears and pretending that they are not hearing. I can't even understand. But it is a serious advice. Now the other one, Fitch affirms Ghana at restrictive default over outstanding Eurobonds default, and that's also in the business news. I'm sure you heard
that. Is that
earlier.
A downgrade or an upgrade?
No.
Affirms.
Yeah, that baby, Aida.
Yeah.
If you're able to reach an agreement with particularly the Eurobond,
yes.
Maybe they would upgrade you. Mm-hmm. But,
And you mentioned the gold, 5 billion in 6 months part, and gold is very expensive nowadays. I mean, the price is going very high. Yeah. That should be good news, right?
Well, all other things being equal.
That means that we'll get a lot of money from it, right?
Depends on how much of it is leaking out of your nation.
Not necessarily. It depends on the agreement you signed.
It was the reference agreement. I thought that now they're...
No. Based on the agreement you've signed, based on... You don't know... I mean, I need to check those agreements again.
It's not for the people, by the people...
How many... What's your stake in gold mines in this country?
Is the gold not for us?
No, you see, when we talk about... deliberately creating Ghanaian millionaires and billionaires, we don't understand. Because if we were creating Ghanaian billionaires, who would get these funds and bring them into the country? The dollars we're talking about here, I will not be walking around begging.
I see people can invest in that sector so that we are not saying that someone should come and put in their money and take it away. Yeah. I still be mentioning big billions. Then yet the amount of money you're getting out of that.
We must that's the thing.
Look, it just like the way when Whistle and Cool to keep talking about per capita income has increased and yet Raymond is in the pocket. Then it's almost as if the inequality is very huge.
Very huge. We must agree that we will create Ghanaian billionaires. Mm-hmm. We can start with existing businessmen and agree that these persons will not be touched irrespective of which government is in power.
The Nigerian model.
Yes, the Nigerian model. As far as once every government that comes into power, you're looking at creating your own.
Sometimes we even reshuffle. So your status is downgraded within 8 or 4 years, then actually upgraded again and over the period anyway.
Well, the graphic business has BOG firmly positioned to mitigate external shocks. Debt struggles continue despite restructuring. Fitch rating improves here. Leverage data, tech in Agric, that's the World Food Program country director there. Mm-hmm. And Paris Olympics, setting standards in legacy and sustainability for future events. It's a piece by Maurice Kwanza. You may want to get the graphic business and read it.
Now, the Daily Dispatch says, I will come back after 4 years for renewal. Mahama will not come back, but I'm here to swing voters. Is the vice president. He said he will come back after 4 years for renewal. So, but Mahama will not come back. So vote for him. That's what the vice president is saying. The other one, let us work together during elections to make Ghana proud. IGP Dampare there. And there's a book review on the front page, part one. Revolution and Democracy in Ghana, The Politics of Jerry Rawlings. That is the Daily Dispatch with those headlines this morning.